Hello, aspirants. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th August. On the front page, you have this news: heavy flooding puts Kerala in crisis. So here we are seeing that red alert has been sounded in 8 districts in Kerala due to rain warnings also now. So heavy discharge is taking place from dams to dams are overflowing, you can see here. Then next is Attorney General lashes out at riots intolerance. So this is a case which has been heard before Supreme Court, and the Attorney General representing the government, he himself has said there is an incident of major rioting every week, even by educated groups. The Marathas in Maharashtra, the SCSTs, nothing is done. So this is his own statement here in the Supreme Court now. Then next is explosives seized from Sanatan man. So this is Maharashtra anti-terrorism squad which has arrested 3 men allegedly planning disruptive activities and, you know, explosives being planted. They're planning so in Maharashtra. Then on page 3 you have this news: compensation enhanced for Kandhamal encounter victims. So 5 villagers here were killed in firing by security forces in July 2016 in Kandhamal district in Odisha. And Odisha Human Rights Commission has now directed state government to enhance compensation to the kin of these victims. On page 5 you have this news: Kanchenjunga Biosphere Reserve enters UNESCO list. So 11 Indian reserves are now on the World Network of Biosphere Reserves in India. So one more has been added here, Kanchenjunga, which is the 3rd highest mountain peak in the world. Then here you have this news: Air India salary is delayed yet again. It is said 5 months in a row pilots have not been paid their salaries. So this is a cause of concern. Air India, which is suffering huge losses, and we are seeing that government tried to sell it off too, but it did not succeed. So here delay in payment of salaries is a huge cause of concern. Down here you have this new center launches portal for scientific research funding. So this is what the government has proposed, that it can have a portal where scientific research funding can take place. So a repository of research know-how will be developed. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial, stooping to conquer. So this is regarding the Rajya Sabha deputy chairman elections, that how BJP was able to get the candidate nominated by it as the deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha, though it does not have majority. The opposition has majority in Rajya Sabha. So this is regarding that. And second editorial, endless war. So this is regarding the war here in Yemen, which is by Saudi-led coalition. So here attacks on civilians, and presently a recent attack on in a marketplace where 45 people were killed and most of them were children has been highlighted. US has also asked for probe investigation into this. UN has also asked for this, and the Saudi government, Saudi coalition itself has now talking of initiating investigation into this particular attack. But this ceaseless attack which is taking place in Yemen on behest of the president of Yemen, who is nowhere to be seen, it is said he is in Saudi Arabia, allegedly to be under house arrest. So this, and Saudi Arabian government says that on his behalf we are fighting against the rebels in Yemen. Rebels have captured the territory in Yemen, including the capital Sana'a, and these are Houthi rebels which are said to be Shia controlled. Shia rebels controlled or backed by Iran. While Iran says, no, we are not backing these rebels. So Iran is Shia dominated, Saudi Arabia is Sunni dominated, and both of them have this ideological conflict too, and they are regional rivals. So this is what is going on in Yemen, which is resulting in a huge humanitarian crisis. The entire government system administration has collapsed over there. The collection of garbage, providing clean water is not being done, because of which even epidemics, cholera epidemic has spread into the country. So it's a huge humanitarian crisis. UN calls it the worst humanitarian crisis presently. So this is there. Then this is the lead article about Boris Johnson, who is the foreign secretary in UK. So you can skip it. This is best of friends, worthy rivals. So this is again regarding Karunanidhi and MGR. You can skip this, again political. On Saturdays, on the op-ed page, there's a Ground Zero article, and this Ground Zero article is the Andaman's new colonizers. So the Indian bullfrog is a recent arrival from the mainland of India into Andaman's, in these group of islands, and it is steadily occupying the island's ecosystem and threatening the local ecosystem. So this is a huge coverage on that, but this much information is sufficient. You don't need to go through the entire page for it. Then on page 8, you have this news. Two MPs bring private bill against lynching. So this is regarding now private member bill also coming forth. You should know what is a private member bill too with respect to quality. So these are bills on lynching. Then on page 9, you have news regarding NRC, but the NRC details would come further after the Supreme Court hearing takes place on mid of August. So we can cover that later. You don't need to have daily coverage on NRC. And this is again regarding fake voters issue, which has been highlighted. Again, this has been heard by the Supreme Court. So further development taking place, we'll have more information. So we can cover that up at that time. This is Pakistan hopes to host SAARC summit. So SAARC summit had been delayed because of India-Pakistan relations strained now. So Imran Khan, who has become the new Prime Minister of Pakistan, is hoping that the SAARC summit, which was to be held in Islamabad, will be hosted soon. It will host it soon. Then on the international page, you have this news. US cuts training for Pakistan military. So this is again a development of significance. This is UK asked to take new approach to immigration. So even India-UK relations are strained because of the visa norms. So industry body in UK now wants Britain to scrap immigration targets and bring immigration also on the trade negotiation table, because Brexit also due presently. UK has to negotiate trade agreements with various entities, various countries. So that is why the industry body here is demanding that UK should take a new approach to immigration now. So this is there. And then 500,000 Venezuelans fleeing crisis enter Ecuador. So again, Venezuela in South America is also facing crisis. Here the financial crisis has emerged because of sanctions against it. So UNHCR is highlighting how here migration is taking place in large numbers, and that is resulting in strain further penetrating. So this has been discussed here. And this is Yemen airstrike, UNSC seeks probe. So this is the same issue which we discussed in the editorial. Then on business page, you have this news. IIP surges to 5-month high of 7%. So IIP is index of industrial production. It also comprises of data regarding 8 core industries. So which are these 8 core industries? You should know about that. What is IIP? What is their weightage in IIP? So such factual data information regarding this indices should be known. But then there will be a monthly detail coming forth about IIP. So you don't need to remember what is the percentage every month, because at the end of the year, when you are attempting prelims, you will not be asked for any particular month. So that is not important. Even within IIP, for the various sectors, what has been the growth rate in the present month is not important. But the background information regarding IIP 8 core sectors is important. And then down here, you have this news. India to triple ethanol production by 2022. So this is an important news regarding even biofuels, how biofuels have to be promoted into the country, what are the targets. Even recently, we had the National Biofuel Policy of 2018. So you should know in detail about that too. Even World Biofuel Day is celebrated on 10th of August. So this is the news in that context. India plans to have 10% ethanol blending with petrol as such. So how that can be achieved, so that is also to be looked into. So this, and how much is presently being done. So it has been made mandatory, but ethanol supply is not sufficient. So all these are the issues you should know in detail about. So these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for today. There's no important news on the last page. And for detailed coverage of current affairs, you can enroll for our course. And you can get the detailed coverage of current affairs PDF on our website too. You can see our monthly PDFs are also available topic wise. Daily PDFs are made available by the end of the day. So you can download them from our website, asha.com. So that is it. Thank you.